Hello, and welcome to Clinically Speaking. I'm Dr. Christine Gilroy, Chief Medical Officer of Express Scripts PBM, part of Evernorth Health Services. Today, we're going to explore three ways the COVID-19 pandemic is affecting overall population health beyond the short-term impacts of the virus. Let's start with a look at cancer care. Due to precautions taken to prevent the spread of COVID-19, especially at the start of the pandemic, we saw a decrease in preventive care, particularly for cancer screenings. Between March and July of 2020, our data showed a decrease in cancer screenings of more than 80%, as well as 25% fewer cancer diagnoses. Even 17 months later, as of December 2021, these numbers had not returned to pre-pandemic levels. Delays in diagnosis and treatment means we can expect an increase in cancer mortality and also in the cost of treatment for cancer care. In fact, cancer costs were expected to increase 40% over the next decade before the pandemic due to increases in medical and pharmaceutical spend. Because of the decrease in cancer screening and diagnosis, we can expect people to be diagnosed at a more advanced stage, which is more costly to care for. However, plan sponsors, in collaboration with providers, can work to mitigate this trend by promoting proper screening, encouraging telehealth visits when appropriate, and by supporting more systemic planning of care. The second impact on population health is around obesity and diabetes, or what we call diabesity. In a survey by the American Psychological Society, 42% of people reported gaining 29 pounds or more between March of 2020 and 2021. And it's not just adults. Pediatric providers are seeing gains of 15 to 20 pounds in middle schoolers across the United States. The COVID-19 virus has also been associated with worsening insulin sensitivity, pancreatic cell death, and fatty liver infiltration. This means people with diabetes, already more prone to COVID-19 infection, experienced a worsening of their diabetes progression after a COVID infection. Similar to the effects on cancer diagnoses, a study in the UK found that actual diabetes diagnoses were 30% lower than expected from 2020 to 2021 due to patients avoiding primary care. As primary care resumes, plan sponsors can expect significant increases in diabetes diagnoses in the next 2 years, as well as increased spending on diabetes care through 2025. Lastly, let's look at long COVID, which is the appearance of prolonged, debilitating symptoms more than 90 days from an initial COVID-19 infection. There are varying reports on the prevalence of long COVID, with some studies indicating it affects 2 to 10% of people who contract the virus, and others citing up to 30%. There are different syndromes associated with long COVID. Convalescent COVID syndrome is characterized by brain fog, ongoing irregularity in heartbeat, and shortness of breath. Chronic fatigue syndrome includes ongoing tiredness not improved by rest. Post-intensive care unit-like syndrome occurs when people have a prolonged loss of conditioning after a hospital stay. And post-traumatic stress disorder is driven by the experience of losing loved ones, a lack of community or socialization, and other related long-term impacts of the pandemic. In many cases, treatment recommendations include increased access to behavioral health care, physical therapy, primary care, and specialty care. As we look to the next 2 to 5 years, these syndromes may result in increased costs among certain disease classes, including blood clotting disorders, heart disease, pulmonary fibrosis conditions, kidney disease, and diabetes. While the pandemic has created sizable challenges for healthcare, we also have more opportunities to address them as we move into this next phase. Increased access to telehealth, advances in home monitoring, and greater investment in coordinating care across pharmacy, medical, and mental health can all significantly improve outcomes. Thanks for joining today. We'll be back in the coming weeks with more Clinically Speaking. Be sure to sign up for weekly news, insights, and updates at evernorth.com. Until the next time, make it your choice to be healthy, be safe, and be well informed every day.